working a coalition on HIV modernization. But the long title for this TED Talk in my head is more like things that we all already know about working in coalitions but are constantly forgetting and having to remind ourselves, and maybe purposely forgetting and having to remind ourselves. Yeah. Okay, so this is gonna feel familiar, but this is a good exercise that I like to go through every single time that we work with a new partner in my head. So lesson one is start the work in the good times. There are no more good times, so start the work now. in working on HIV modernization, we started working on this issue about 3 years ago. We were one of the founding organizations of our state's Louisiana Coalition on Criminalization and Health that was working to build up community education, research, advocacy, training, in order to create an infrastructure for modernizing our HIV law in Louisiana, which is one of the worst in the country in a lot of ways. And because we started the work several years ago, we were significantly more prepared for what happened to us this year, which was that a piece of legislation that was meant to be an effort to modernize our HIV law that was really, really awful got filed. And we still weren't able to stop it, but what we were able to do was prevent a lot of harm. And so the bill that ended up passing was significantly less harmful than it would have been otherwise, it would have been completely impossible for us to step into that space if we hadn't started years ago talking about this issue. So again, start the work now. Open communication builds trust. For me, and for I think a lot of you, one of the biggest things that sets off my bullshit radar is when people who want to be a partner or who want to work with your organization or work inside of your coalition will only talk to one or two of the people that are part of that coalition. What we figured out earlier this year was that there was a partner who was a service provider, a regional service provider for people living with HIV in our state, who ultimately ended up being the folks that were responsible for getting that bad bill filed, who would only talk to one or two people in our coalition but wanted to be a coalition partner. And we figured out it was because there was a purposeful effort to keep information from the rest of the group, because they would know that it was a big red flag, right? So open communication equals trust. Even if you're not doing this, like, just make sure that you're talking to everyone, because then no one will have any reason to call bullshit on you. Beware the drift. So this is for any coalition. We all have different perspectives when we come to work with partners on anything that we're working with them on. And we all want to save the world, right? Like, we want to do everything, and we're constantly sitting in meetings where all of a sudden we've crafted like the big 20-year progressive agenda for our state, right? Anyone done that? Yes? No, don't do that. Stop doing that. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't be looking at what the different pieces are for systemic change, right? So if you're in a coalition about HIV modernization, it does actually make sense for you to take a look at the other HIV policies that could be interacting with criminalization of HIV in your state. So an example that we had was there was a mandatory testing law that we didn't even know about because it was in a completely different part of the statute. But it was an obvious interaction with the criminalization of people living with HIV, because when they came in contact with a person in law enforcement and there was a so-called exposure, right, that's the language that's in the law, it would trigger mandatory testing, which if someone got testing done in a coercive way and then tested positive for HIV, it would trigger this criminalization. No burning bridges, final lesson. How many times have you sat in a coalition meeting and wanted to just burn it all down and walk away and never come back? All the time, right? You can't do that, because you need these folks and they need you, and you have to make sure that you're able to maintain those relationships. Thank you.